What is up, everyone? Welcome back to my channel. This is the third part of interview experience. I have also uploaded two more interview experiences previously of Rohan and Nandini. If you haven't watched that, please go and watch it because it will help you definitely in your interview for TCS. So this is the third interview experience of Ayan, who is an electrical brand student, and I am going to share some more interview experiences only after you subscribing my channel. So please subscribe my channel, and if you like the video, please hit the like button after seeing the video. So yeah, let's get started. Okay, so there were two panel members for Ayan. Actually, it depends on the availability of the employees of TCS. The interview experiences that I shared before this video were having three panel members, and for Ayan, there were only two panel members. That is, one was HR and the other one was TR, that is technical interviewer. Okay, so let's start with his video. Okay. So the first, very first common question is, tell me about yourself. Now, I already suggested few points in previous videos as well. So if you haven't watched that, please go and watch it. And I'll share some more points in this video as well. So in tell me about yourself, you should keep it quiet. Do not exaggerate there. Do not keep it very short, or do not keep it very long. Keep it simple and medium kind of introduction. So in this, you can tell them, you can start it with, my name is dash and dash, I am a computer science student, or you can say, I am pursuing computer science in this and this college. I'll complete my graduation in this year, that is 2021. Or if you are already graduated, then you can say, I completed my engineering in the year 2020 or whatever. Next, you can tell them if you have done any internships. That is, suppose if I have done two internships, so I can tell them, like, along with this, I have completed two internships in the companies named as so and so, and my role was so and so. So you can tell them according to your internships. After that, you can also share the projects that you have done. Now I am saying these points because if you told them some about any coding language or any subjects, so your interview will be on that only. So be careful while telling the introduction. Next. Okay, so after that, the interviewer asks, have you learned any subjects related to CS or IT branch? So Ayan is an electrical branch student, and obviously the electrical student is applying for an IT company, so this question is quite expected by the interviewer. So Ayan told me that he told the interviewers that he knows DBMS and C language in the coding. Okay, so he told that. So the interviewer said, okay, so tell me, what is normalization? Now this is a DBMS question, that is database management system question. And also I have uploaded a very brief explanation in a video that I uploaded recently about DBMS and OOPs. So if you want to learn basics of DBMS and OOPs in just half an hour, then you can watch my video. I'll share the link in description. So what is normalization? Normalization is the process of minimizing redundancy from a relation or set of relations. सो दैट्स इट. यू कैन गूगल द आंसर और व्हाट आई टोल्ड यू कैन लर्न दैट. पॉज द वीडियो एंड टेक अ पेन एंड पेपर, राइट इट डाउन एंड प्रिपेयर इट. ओके, सो नेक्स्ट, हाउ मेनी टाइप्स ऑफ जॉइंट्स आर देयर एंड व्हाट आर दे. सो रोहन सेड दैट he told them four that there are four types of join, that is inner join, left join, right join and full join. So and if you want to learn the about the joints in brief with brief explanation, you can watch my video. Okay, I'll tell you which video I am talking about. See, I'm talking about this video, like the TCS interview questions important for non-CS or IT students. You can watch this video if you want the deep and very clear explanation just in 32 minutes. So you can watch this. Also, I have uploaded the Rohan Verma's interview experience for TCS NQT for Ninja Profile, and also I have yesterday uploaded the interview experience of Nandini Jaiswal, who is an CS student and Rohan was electronics student. So you can watch these videos. So the next question was, how much will you rate yourself in coding? So this is a quite tricky question, and it can be a question in which it will be decided whether you will get selected or rejected. So be careful while answering this type of tricky questions, because in this they are actually wanted to know your confidence or overconfidence. You are confident enough or not, they are checking that. And in this, I can suggest that if you are a CS or IT student, you should answer it like, and if you are really really good in coding, then you can answer like, I'll rate myself 8 to 9 out of 10. But if you are average in coding, then you can tell them that I can rate myself as 6 to 8 out of 10, because as I am a fresher, I am learning few more topics in coding. So like this. And if you are a non-CS or IT student, you can tell them that I can, sir or ma'am, I can rate myself as 3 to 5 coding, but I am learning to code, and I'll make sure to increase my rating in coding. So you can tell them like this. Because as you are a non-CS or IT student, they are not expecting a coder, that you must be a coder or whatever. They just wanted to know your mentality, that are you even started learning coding, or are you just giving this interview for job purpose. Okay, so now the HR started asking him questions. So the first question was, how electrical and CS branch related? See, the HR will obviously ask you tricky questions if you are a non-CS or IT student, but they can ask CS or IT students also the tricky questions. As you are not of CS or IT field or branch, you should be well prepared for this type of questions. Just exclude electrical, and you can put your branch like mechanical or civil in this question, and just be ready with this answer, because they'll ask you. This is a very expected question for you from the interviewer if you are a non-CS or IT student. So how electrical and CS branch related? Now you have to be yourself there and tell them that the advantages of being an electrical student and still knowing the knowledge of CS. You have more knowledge than your field, and also you can put a point like, you are keen in learning new technologies, so you are interested in CS or IT field or IT company, like that. So it is टोटली बेस्ड ऑन योर मेंटालिटी एंड वॉट यू थिंक. सो द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज वाई डू यू वॉन्ट टू वर्क इन आई टी कंपनी आफ्टर लर्निंग इलेक्ट्रिकल स्ट्रीम फॉर 4 years. सी आई टोल्ड यू दैट दिल आस्क दिस क्वेश्चन टू ईच एंड एवरी स्टूडेंट probably in the interview if you are a non-CS or IT student. So tell them the decision, why do you want to work in IT or why do you choose IT field for your career. So tell them that. Next, how will you compete with CS or IT students? So now this is again a very expected question from the interviewer. So yeah, that's it. This was the interview experience of Ayan, who is an electrical student. And if you like the video, please hit the like button. Also, please subscribe to my channel. Only after which I'll share few more interview experiences that you want. So please comment down below that which branch interview experience do you want to see or do you want to learn about. So yeah, that's it. Let's meet in the next video. Bye bye.